that works.
See? Now go stand over there, please. Yep.
Is the laundry coming in today? She's sick.
Oh, no.
Anna's sick.
Oh, no.
So I've got two group activities to do.
Oh,
no. Do you want to join in?
I'd love to.
Oh,
that's
yeah. So yeah. So that's
what that is.
Here. Oh, excellent. Thank
Sorry.
You.
So I can sit up here and move this, and then just come up there. We just did a thing where you kind of do that or do that, and then I just come up and go pew and change it. It's no big deal.
I bet there's only 6 slides.
Oh, that's
it. Yeah. Yeah. Like PowerPoint.
I think we need to have a chat, Tash, about the VRA steering committee on Monday.
Does that have to be now? Can it be after our meeting?
Well, there's going to be we're going to have to send down an agenda. The terms are ready to set that on to the committee meeting.
Few,
oh, awesome. Okay.
You've already got it.
I haven't looked at my emails. I haven't been around.
Yeah. We've already got the terms of reference. You've already got the agenda. And you've already got the document that. Karen sent out the basically the guidelines that she's already.
Okay.
What she's going to do and what she's going to do with it.
Okay.
That's how you represent
it.
So they're all set with
it. Okay. So Sharon isn't attending. Sharon's meeting again.
Which is painful because we moved the meeting for Sharon.
I know. And it's difficult for me to get there at that time because I dropped Bonnie off on a Monday and I've just been told. So I'm trying to get in contact with Ian, but he has meetings on Monday mornings, which is why I'm on drop off. So I'm just going to have to do the best I can to get there in time. So we can have a conversation about that and maybe run through some stuff that you can discuss if I don't make it at 9 o'clock.
Well, I'm just going to
be pushing it.
Turn it to Karen, really.
Yeah,
and
so we probably need to just have a conversation with her today.
Did you get the email? She's been...
That's nice
for her. Yeah, it's great for her. We just need to know what's going to happen with the work.
Well, if she doesn't do it, then we don't have to pay her. Maybe we can get back something to do instead.
I think she would.
Well, she signed the contract.
Exactly.
Like, she agreed to do it.
She's already been given some more, hasn't she? Still hasn't happened.
No, because the agreement was that upon delivery of the first item, she'd get paid part of it. Delivery of the second item, she'll get paid part of it. Delivery of the last report, then she'll get paid the final bit.
She got an amount on signing contract, didn't she?
Yeah. That's not part of the contract.
Oh, Sharon realizes that's what she did. It wasn't in the spec that you get the first amount on signing contract.
Yeah. It's delivery on things. That's what I've been looking at. And one of the things is due today, I don't know if she knows that or not.
Okay.
But that's, I double checked everything because I was okay, I've never done this before, so I made sure that everything was.
Okay.
And the first thing, it's 3 payments.
Yeah.
And each payment is upon delivery of upon item.
Okay. All right, well, probably need to give her a call today and make sure she delivers what she's supposed to deliver today.
Yeah.
And run through what's going to happen on Monday.
Okay. I spoke to her yesterday. She's just like, yeah, she was just like, oh, yeah, that's okay. Just get to come in. She's worked within here so often and she knows most of the people that are coming anyway. So she's not really bothered.
Yeah.
She's pretty easy coming. So she just said, look, print off a couple of bits of the agenda, print off a couple of the specs in case nobody has printed or looked at it yet. Truth be told, I think there's only going to be 6 of us in the room and everyone else will be calling in.
Right.
So I don't think there'll be many people physically in. And yeah, she's just gonna pretty much go through the spec and just say, this is what we have to do. I might be contacting you and your staff to ask you for information on this and that. And can you just let everyone be aware, pretty much. That's all it's gonna be. It's not gonna be, I mean, she might read through the terms of reference because everybody's agreed.
Well, that's our job.
Agreeing to
do that.
That's it, there's nothing else.
Yeah.
That's why it's only an hour.
So we'll have to get people to endorse the terms of reference, start off, and that's our job. That's cool. We'll have a chat about it after the meeting then.
After this, then I'll come to our meeting, and then after that I'll stay back and wait.
Alright, our meeting's at 10:30.
Yeah, but I'll be a bit late because this is going to take, these presentations are supposed to take up to 40 minutes.
Yeah, well, we're going to have to rethink that because I've got the meeting scheduled.
Yep.
So I want to move with that. So that's going to have to happen.
We can.
And if there's only two of you guys today, you don't need to do it at that time. You can shift it, can't you?
Sure.
I mean, well, what needs to happen?
Four people have to be in attendance.
All right.
Plus
we've got
the presenter.
Jason and Shane, so we're just trying to.
Shane's
pardon?
Not here.
Oh,
is
Shane's
this the room that Julianne's in?
Yes.
Okay, because she just
came
sit
down there.
At the okay, cool.
All right, yeah, because I need you at the team meeting.
Yeah.
So there's no point in having it. But Cherie's calling in for the team meeting as well, so I need to have that.
Yeah, but I'd only be there, like, miss out on 10 minutes.
Oh, I thought you said 40 minutes.
No, this goes for 40 minutes.
Right.
If we start now, I'll only miss out on, like, 10, 15 minutes of our meeting.
Okay.
Not the whole thing.
Well, I'll postpone it. For half an hour, so just make sure you're there at 11 then, and I'll get everyone to be there at 11.
I just said we've got Jasmine and Shane. Shane's not here either.
No.
Alright, 3 is better than 0. Where's this gone? Huh? There we go. Just the arrows. It's just the arrows.
The only reason that we couldn't first off is because we couldn't because of the phone line.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Oh, thanks, Chloe. The trainers are going to come in.
Oh, good.
I just got to tell Scott. He's listening.
Oh, cool. Then I can stay back.
Can you put the email? Just for that college.
Yeah.
Just go through them. Just be like, hey, I just need
to. Do we need
quote.
Any more chairs?
I
need one for me.
Just be like Chloe. I needed Chloe for like 4 months. I hope that's so I don't get in trouble. He's like, where's Chloe? I'll get. Because I was with Catherine 2 seconds ago, and I'm now.
Hi,
that thing called?
Do I need any information for this?
No.
I see what you mean.
Yeah, so because of that, we could only do it. But once we're logged in, we can take that back out.
You don't really need the internet, right? She's not showing a video. Is she showing a video?
I think to get on Citrix, you have to.
Yeah, but now, what are we running?
Just a PowerPoint, I believe. That's all that we're doing.
Chloe, do you know if we've got to keep this computer working and to keep that on up there? Do we need this to be plugged into the internet? So we can unplug it from the internet.
It should be wireless.
Yeah. Is it?
Yeah. I don't think there should be a problem.
We'll just see if we can move it closer.
I haven't logged into the Wi-Fi on that.
That's
computer.
Okay. So don't
know. Oh, what am I doing?
Yeah, that works.
Yeah, it should be fine.
Good.
Hi, guys.
Move it closer. Just sit down.
Recording anything, I'm still working out where to set up.
It's been recorded, isn't it?
Yeah, so I'll just fill you in. So thank you very much, people. Vanessa's part of our little group, and we've been doing a couple of units through TAFE on training and assessment. So not the whole certificate four in training and assessment, but only needs to do 5 units. And our assessments require us, we've done one presentation in person, we have to do one that's recorded, and then we actually have to do a third one, which is all just written. So we were booked in for today with the rest of our group, which consisted of 6 people, and it's just been Vanessa and myself. And Vanessa has travelled from Wyong today, Wyong office today. So, and my little session, I've just got 2 activities to do. And I couldn't just so thank you very much for coming here. Do you want to just quickly go around the room and introduce yourself before we start
recording?
So yeah, so are you okay that I'm recording it?
Yeah, I did this recently. I know.
Okay, yes. So and then it just goes to the teacher from tonight. So
ready? Mm-hmm. Okay, well, Tommy, wait, am I recording this or
no,
not?
No, not yet.
Okay, good. Just checking.
Well, I'm Chloe. I work in Scott Singleton for a year at the moment, but before I was Jamie's assistant.
Here to help out.
Okay. Yes. Well, I'm Vanessa. I was working in the housing tech team, but I've gone back to Wyong now. So I'm working in the tenancy team up in Wyong.
And I'm Mari, and I work in the new LEAP program, so
I'm Denise, and same as when I work on the same team with Ted, Sydney Housing.
I'm Wendy, and I'm currently working in the TAFE
team. I'm Martin, I'm the same as Mario Denise, I'm the subject matter expert in the TAFE program for LEAP.
So Martin will be able to critique us quite well.
Yes,
because he actually's got the certificate 4 in this.
I know how awkward it is. this is God's. I had to do it with my family.
Oh, you did it with your family.
40 minutes.
Yeah,
they actually really enjoyed it.
Did they?
I was expecting them to go.
You got that water?
No,
you just
really
put it next to you or something. Yeah, just trying to get them, both of them. Can, if we could just move them to the side a bit. Because they're just projecting up anything. I'm Tash, everybody knows me. No, I work in the same team as Juliana, I'm a project officer. And I do whatever I'm told, usually to do with refugees at the moment. So if you need to know anything on refugees, then just come and let me know.
All right, so look, once again, thank you very much. Okay, so we might start.
Okay.
That's a nice photo of my kids there. Okay, so we'll look at the first method, and it is called it's called the GROW model. So it's a very simple method for goal setting and problem solving. It was developed in the UK and used pretty extensively in the 80s and the 90s. It seems to be pretty well suited for identifying and working on and solving problems in business areas. And it's broken down to four elements. Next one, Tish. So the GROW method talks about setting the goal or finding the goal or identifying what the goal is that you want to get to at the end. Looking at what obstacles are stopping you from getting there, and then the obstacles then help you turn those into, you know, what are the options. So this is the obstacle, this is the option. And then W for the way forward. So how do you convert those options into actions that help you get to your goal? Often with the GROW model, the SMART objectives, you know, so the acronym SMART around setting your goals is useful to help you identify what your goal would be. Are you all familiar with the SMART method of setting goals? You know, so that it's specific, measurable, it's achievable, it's relevant, and it's time bound. So applying that SMART principle to setting some goals will help keep it on track and also help sort of draw out from the team or from the employee that you're working with, you know, something that's actually for them, they've got some personal interest in achieving as well. So we'll just take a few, about 10 minutes. So we're just going to break into just a couple of groups. I'll give you some paper. And just using these stages, the G, R, O, and W, if you could think about something, you know, if you're a team leader, and you know, as a lot of you have come from housing operations areas, where you're measuring KPIs and you know, all those sorts of things. If you can recall a problem that you've had and maybe applying this method, some of the steps that you would take to you know, the goal, what you would do, and then the way forward. So I'll give you about 7 minutes, if that's okay, and then at the end of that, we'll come back and we'll just have a quick chat, and then we'll move on to the second method and see how we go in that scenario.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Okay. Let's do it. Okay.
What colour do you want?
That's a good one. Yeah, we can do quite quantifiable by
thinking. Because I'm thinking that's quite.
So you have it and you
yeah.
approach that. So.
Which could be good.
Yeah.
I'll just leave the Mrs. Mark criteria on the table for you if you anyone wanted to refer to that.
Oh, right.
I'm
thinking
I was thinking
of a situation we had in where I was from, where we had certain occupational services and had certain amount of people that we needed to meet the similar sort of KPIs. And what we did is divide the teams up into streams to meet that goal and work really, really well. So I was just thinking of that, because that's
actually,
we had to meet.
So how did you find that, guys? Did you find that is this a way that you have looked at solving problems before, or is it similar to something that you've done before? Brand new?
Yeah.
Thinking of SMART too when I was doing it, but I think this is a much bigger picture process.
Yes.
So
yeah.
Whereas SMART tends to drill down to specifics, which is good, but this tends to be much more macro.
And it's something that you could probably apply in a team setting, a group setting. Do you want to just quickly just go through your issue?
What we were sort of addressing when we were looking at the GROW was underperformance, and we drilled that down because that's very broad. So we were looking at meeting KPIs and client service visits. Yeah, oh sorry, yeah. Oh. Just, yeah. Do you want me to sort of put on the wall now being that's good? Yeah. So when we were looking at the GROW, so G was to we're looking at enabling staff to meet targets. So that was the aim of the process. So looking at various competing priorities, so these are the issues impacting.
So there were some of your reality.
So reality,
yeah.
It's various competing priorities in a team, stopping staff from completing targets. So obstacles we could see were workloads, interpersonal issues, so that can be sort of conflict and cultural issues, technical issues when homes dies, morale, unplanned leave, and staff cuts. Okay, and the way forward, we were looking at how to motivate staff, better planning, more effective use of rosters, management support, so that can be support from team leaders, you know, trying to sort of raise the morale in their teams, and where possible, because it's not always possible, but renegotiating realistic targets based on the above.
Excellent, great, thank you. Nice. Do you want me to put yours up?
Yeah.
hot topic.
Yeah.
I just noticed that.
Oh, yeah.
And I'll talk to you outside of this session, but this is what my first one was about.
So the reality is that the visits weren't happening at all, or very little visits were happening, and you weren't meeting the KPIs. Reporting wasn't being done because of the home's procedures, so people weren't coming back and updating homes, and it wasn't being reported that that had been done. The reality is that the tenancies weren't being managed and people weren't actually going out there doing visits. The obstacles, the time to set up for a client service visit, it's very time consuming, and coming back, the things you have to do afterwards. Workloads again, direction from senior managers. So we're saying here, there's no report that a client service officer gets that identifies what problems have been inspected or needs to be inspected. That would normally come from the managers and that about, what ones you haven't visited, and that could have been that that wasn't happening, so it wasn't being fed back down to staff. And then training as well, so that could have been one of the obstacles as well. So we've gone to options and we've looked at having a support person to plan the CSVs, and that then takes the workload off the CSOs as well. And the way forward is that that business support officer sends out appointments and manages the visits that need to be done. So
yeah, all that administrative work. Yes.
And updating, the homes and things like that to make sure that it's been updated.
Excellent.
And that is.
Did you find that method easier? A bit more difficult, a bit of time to think, how do I get on, what is the actual, what is the goal and what's the reality? Was it simple to put into practice in a workplace scenario?
Yeah.
Alright, excellent. So our next method is called how to solve it. So Tash? So How to Solve It is a small volume by a mathematician, George Pollier, and it's a system of thinking to help solve a problem. It was developed for mathematical problems, but it seems to work quite well when it's applied in the workplace. And again, it just is based on four simple principles. And they are, first, you have to understand the problem. Secondly, after you understand the problem, you make a plan. Third is carrying out the plan. And then four is looking back on your plan. And could I have done it better? Simple. Four principles, a little bit different to the GROW model, but where GROW was identifying your goal, this one's actually understanding the problem. And I suppose to identify your goal, you understand your problem. So they just sort of turn some of the language around the other way. So if we take your same problems again, and then try and look at it in these four principles, and then we'll just have a look and see whether we have the same thinking or different thinking. This makes us think a different way to the GROW model. This way might be a bit easier for us to apply in the workplace, and then we'll have a chat afterwards. So.
Why
to me first.
The reality of it and what the obstacles are. So we're looking at
I mean, some tips around the first one.
So what is the tip? Is it just
you have to understand the core root? Like some of the questions you could ask yourself is, can you think of a picture or a diagram that might help you understand the problem? Is there enough information for you to be able to find a solution to the problem? Do you understand what you've been asked to, you know, like, do you understand what it is that's sort of the problem? So as you said, the, you know, why, how, sometimes can help unpack, you know, what is the problem.
So if we go, we measure that problem,
so understanding the problem,
you know,
why it was happening.
What is that? Is that just going into the pain? Is it the report of it? Is it getting into the pain? What is, you need to understand what the specific measurable is first, so we can then go right and work back. So how would you like it? You could ask the question, what is the task? You're talking about physical, not your physical. This is the and the tendency too.
They don't have time.
I mean, the whole package of it.
Sure.
You know? And we forget that. We forget that, you know, something as simple as having a car makes all the difference.
Yes.
Maybe just for the purpose of today, because we're a little bit time poor, if you just pick one of the whys, and then that can be what you make your plan around. So you might just go, okay, well actually, it's really about training. The reason why we're not doing it is because our staff aren't trained enough. So then you could just maybe work your plan around just one element of the why. Oh, it could be about the car. You know, you could go, actually, we need two cars. So we need to put up some sort of a bid for another car, and we've got the resource to get out and do it. Yeah, so maybe just pick one element and go, well, what will we do around that car?
Well, if we do the one, because really from an organisation,
Thank you.
assistance, and I'd also say engagement around raising the
That's right. Really, more money just fixes the problem.
And it might be that you get your team on board and you trial it for a period. So that you can, you know, four is going back and looking at your plan. So part of your plan might be and at the end of it, so we're going to start on Monday, we're going to go for 8 weeks, and then the following Monday, I'm going to set a team meeting, we're all going to come back in, we're going to look at how well it worked, and if it did or if it didn't, and then you know, take it from there.
Absolutely.
If we get more staff.
Which,
So now you just run it for a trial period. So your plan might be that all these words here, you actually turn it into a process. You get, you know, group agreement, and this will be your this will be the process. So how did you find that method? A bit easier? Different? Better? So in a workplace environment, a bit more time consuming, do you think, the how to solve it model? Do you think it might deliver different results than something to the grow model?
Personally, I think if you're going to be able to spend enough time on something like this and you can work it out, then it might last you longer. It's more of a longer term proposal, something you can, as opposed to how we actually came up with our stories.
Okay, so the purpose of today was just to show you, as part of this broader certificate that you're doing in leadership and management, some of the skill that you need as a leader, and this is just one small component today. It was about problem solving. Just the next, I saw this little saying the other day, and held something close to my heart. Sometimes we think problems are, you know, much bigger than what they are, and I often say to myself now, but is it just as simple as, it's not about right or wrong, it's about more effective. So how can our solution be more effective? So I just sort of wanted to throw that in today, just to, you know, give you another a thought around problems. Sometimes we let our problems become way bigger than what they actually are. Break it down, keep it small. Hopefully the grow method is one way that you might be able to apply it in the workplace. How to solve it. You can see how to solve it, how it grew from a mathematical point of view. It seems to be a little bit more structured, and it makes you think in a structured way, where the grow model is a little bit more organic. You know, let's set the goal first, and sometimes, you know, setting a goal can be very fluffy, where when you drill down and you try and understand what the problem is, it helps you have a bit more concrete structure to what's happening. Next, I spoke a little earlier about some of the resources that FACTS have. So looking at solving problems or applying these methods in a work-related area where it's about underperformance, You can go to the performance development program, that's the link there, also the career planning and development. But also, I'm not sure if many of you know, we have a behavioural insights unit, and they have some very good information around engagement, motivation. When you're working with people and it's around trying to lift performance, a lot of it is around personal motivation. And if you can't get people personally motivated in things, you're probably not going to see a lot of change in output or effort. So they have some really, really, really good documents that you can have a read through there. So that brings us to the close of our session today. Thank you very much for coming. I know that you've all taken some time out of your day to come and help out this morning. I hope it's covered in giving you some thought around some different methods to solving problems today. That was what the session was planned around. And hopefully this small component of this will lead very nicely into our next unit, which is about showing leadership in the workplace. Leadership, solving problems, you know, sort of go hand in hand. So next week in our session, when we're looking at showing leadership in the workplace, you'll have, hopefully, a tool around, well, okay, I've got a couple of different ways that I can solve problems. So, you know, that will help me go into that one. So thank you very much. I do have a small feedback sheet. If I could ask you all to just quickly do that. That would be fantastic. So thank you very much, everyone. And that's a wrap. Thank you.